Hello, John Carroll. I'm Luis Jimenez.
I'm Chris Barreau.
And this is JCTV News.
Beyond the headlines.
Up first, we have a story on softball and their fundraiser conducted by Hallie.
Hi, everyone. It's Hallie Baker here to give you an update on the softball fundraiser.
The softball team is starting to sell chocolate to raise money so we can get a fence and possibly turn our whole softball field around. The average student can help out by finding a softball team player and giving them a dollar to buy chocolate. We have regular like milk chocolate, we have dark chocolate, like the crispy kind, and caramel chocolate.
Okay, everyone, so make sure you come out and support the softball team by buying chocolate. Thanks.
Thanks, Holly, for the report on softball. And up next, we have Deja with the weather.
What's up, JC? This is Deja with your weekly weather. Thursday, we will have a high of 76 with a low of 54 and a 0% chance of rain. And Friday, we'll have a high of 78 with a low of 55 with a 10% chance of rain. Make sure you have your jackets for the game. Saturday, we'll have a high of 80 with a low of 57 with a 10% chance of rain. Sunday, we'll have a high of 84 with a low of 60 and a 10% chance of rain. And Monday, we'll have a high of 87 with a low of 63 and a 0% chance of rain. Tuesday, we'll have a high of 88 and a low of 64 with a 0% chance of rain. Fun fact, Port Martin, Antarctica is the windiest place on the earth. It has about 40 miles per hour each year. Back to you, Louise and Chris.
All right, thanks, Deja. Up next, we have sports with Joe Kane.
Thanks, Louise. John Kerry got their first win this season. Here's a couple highlights from that game.
Had their game tonight against Helena. Make sure to support Cavs. And also, the cross country have their meet this weekend, the Jesse Owens track meet in Moulton, Alabama. Make sure to support Cavs. Back to you, Louise.
Thanks, Joe. And up next, we have our school president, Noah Smith.
Hello, everybody. It's Noah coming to you from Madison Square Garden. This week, we have Homewood away at Homewood at 7 o'clock on Friday. So go out and support your Cavs. The freshmen have a retreat on Friday, so let's pray for them. NHS has begun tutoring in the library on Tuesdays, and you can schedule an appointment on the website if you go to Students and then Resources if you want a specific subject to be tutored to you by the National Honor Society. And then let's all congratulate Ms. Tarbox. She has just given birth to a baby Tarbox.
All right, thanks, Noah. And when we come back from our commercial break, we will be looking into which restroom is closest to the library.
Oh, hey. Steroids affect thousands of students across the country every day. And as you see, that's not the best thing possible. So it's time that we take a stand against the use of anabolic steroids.
Hey Will, what do you think about steroids, man?
Avoid the roids. He needs to avoid the roids.
He definitely needs to avoid the roids.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Also, don't hurt you.
Avoid the roids.
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 He does, doesn't he?
He does.
Please, avoid the roids.
So, Chris, have you ever been in the library and wondered which restroom was closer to you?
That's actually like a daily struggle for me. Like, I'm always in the library and I'm always wondering. I actually spend maybe like a whole minute wondering which restroom I should go to.
Yeah, it's a struggle for me too. Last week, I was really thinking about it and I decided to take matters into my own hands.
Okay.
I decided to find out which restroom really was closer. So what happened was I counted the amount of steps. I took it from the entrance to the library down to the orange restroom. It was about 37 steps.
Okay.
And then what I did is I counted steps from the exit of the library down to the purple restroom, and it was 55 steps.
Oh, 55 steps.
So there was a significant difference in the number of steps. And of course, since we have two different doors in the library, the difference between them two was 31 steps going from one entrance to the other.
Okay.
So it kind of has to do with specifically where you are in the library, but generally speaking, the orange restroom is closest.
Okay. All right. Thanks.
So now we know. Anyways, up next we have Will Beasley with a review on Suicide Squad, which a lot of critics hated, but I thought it was pretty good. So let's see what Will has to say about that.
Thanks, guys. And this week, I'm going to be reviewing Suicide Squad for you guys. And there's a lot of hate for this movie, and I thought it was just absolutely an awesome movie to see. The story, okay, yes, the story is not the great, it's not good. But who cares? You go to see Suicide Squad to see the characters. And the main characters in here are great. Harley Quinn, Joker. Actually, Joker was a little weird. I mean, most of the times, his and Harley's relationship is the textbook abusive relationship, but here he seems to really genuinely care about her. Oh well, I liked it. Deadshot, Colonel Flagg, and Amanda Waller. I have to say that this rendition of Amanda Waller is probably my favorite since the Justice League cartoon series. And even though our main characters are so great and are great to see go on whatever journey it is they're supposed to be going on this movie, the side characters are also still just a lot of fun to see and be around, with Killer Croc, Captain Boomerang, who honestly could have been better, Katana, El Diablo, just all of them I thought worked fantastically off of one another. And it's just a really nice thing to see all these characters be in the same place and just do their own thing and play off one another. And does me being a DC fanboy help me to enjoy this movie more than others? Yeah, probably. Overall, I give this movie a 9.4 out of 10. Back to you, Luis and Chris.
Thanks, Will, for the report on Suicide Squad. And hey, bro, do you like games?
I used to play video games.
Oh, seriously? Well, maybe you should join the gaming club. Yeah, actually, Kyle's going to tell us about that.
Think you can game? Got any games on your phone? Well, today, I have Abraham and Patrick to tell us a little bit about gaming club.
Play a lot of Nintendo games. We play Xbox games, we play pretty much anything that we're allowed to. I mean, here, GTA, because full of blood and death, and it's not really that fun to play as a group.
And obviously, if you can turn down the violence, we can think about it. But most likely, we'll be sticking to cartoon violence, such as Smash.
Have a fun place that they could just meet other people that like video games after school, or just gaming in general, every Thursday and Friday. Because, you know, a lot of people don't know that they have people that at the school that like games too.
And
And where do you guys meet for this video game club?
We meet in the library every Thursday and Friday from the end of school to 5:30, isn't it?
4:30.
Nah.
It starts at 3:30 and it goes till 4:30 every Thursday and Friday.
But then on special occasions, we push it to 5. However, that's usually a rare moment.
Come on, JC, show your skills, and I'll see you at Gaming Club. Back to you, Chris.
Thanks, Kyla. And, hey, can I close this time?
Sure.
No, like, I really want to close.
Okay, okay.
Okay, fine. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Hey, Chris, you have to say it out loud.
Huh?
You have to say it out
loud. Okay, you do it.
Okay, this is why I usually do it.
Okay.
Okay. All right, that's all. All right, that's all, folks. I'll see you next week on JCTV News Beyond the Headlines.